I try to reach you, but you're so hot that I'm melting. I fell right through the cracks. Now I'm trying to get back before the cool done run out. I'll be giving it my best, and nothing's gonna stop me but divine intervention. I reckon it's again my turn to win some or learn some, but I won't hesitate. No more, it cannot wait. I'm yours. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Hey.
All right, welcome back to another episode of Morning Coffee with Rick Alexander. I'm going to jump right into this one because I think this is a commonly debated and commonly misunderstood topic. It's about change. Do people change? So I said a while ago that people don't change. They evolve. And so here, let me try to give you this theory in under a minute. But essentially, if you could think about it as you, there's a version of you in the future that is the highest expression of who you could be. It's like you've maximized your potential health, wealth, emotional, mentally, every single area of your life. That would be the highest expression of your life. Now, every day, you're making decisions that are going to help evolve you toward the highest expression of who you could be or away from it. And so I don't believe that people change. I believe that they evolve. I believe that's in our nature. That's what we do. But one of the reasons we can't just go cold turkey and decide to be better or watch a Tony Robbins seminar and then go home and implement all the things that we've been excitingly planning in our head. I've not seen Tony Robbins, but you get what I mean, right? It's like, how many times have you gone to a conference or read a book or listened to a podcast or got yourself really friggin' excited, and then all of the plans in your head, you get back to the world kind of pushes you back into your box and you never implement all the things you were excited and thinking about. But the reason is because we, and I mean humans, are too naive to our own problems, meaning we're not fully aware of them. We are psychologically evolved to lie to ourselves and to exaggerate our importance in order to make ourselves feel better about how we are really doing in life. And we willfully remain blind to most of our faults because if we don't, we'll really have to face them. And believe me, our own ideals are the biggest judges that we'll ever face in this life. To live up to your own ideal is the most intimidating thing that you can try and live up to in this life. And I think if you're being honest with yourself, you'll find that you too are a bit intimidated to live up to your best self. And you might think that's stupid. You might think, why would I be intimidated of that? Because your best self assumes that you've nailed every aspect of your life. From where you are right now, all possible potential futures exist in front of you. There are literally endless possibilities of what could unfold after this present moment. But guess what? Your own ideal is the absolute highest unfolding of all possible futures. Your ideal is the best possible scenario in every aspect of your life, which means of all the unfoldings, you expect yourself to reach the highest. And so, yeah, you're damn right, it's hard to live up to that, as it should be. And look, because you are constantly sort of combing your life for your faults, you become aware of a lot of them, and then it seems like too big of a leap to your own ideal. And so, yes, in light of your present uphill battle to become your actual best self, you've evolved to lie to yourself. We both know that the chances of you actually becoming as self-actualized as your ideal self are pretty limited. But that's just me being realistic, because this is life. But since when are the odds not stacked against you? Just because the battle is a bit uphill doesn't mean it's not worth embarking on. You have a problem when the chances are zero. But guess what? Your heartbeat is proof that a chance still remains. For whatever you want to do, whatever self-actualized looks to you, the chances are not good, but they're not zero. In fact, every moment you're given is another chance to do a little better, to evolve toward that person, to be a little better. I think I've told this story on the podcast a few times, but it really stuck with me. I was listening to this astronaut talk about the fact that he wanted to become an astronaut, and everyone he told was like, yeah, it's not going to happen. The chances are like 0.015% or whatever they are. And every time he would be like, oh, okay, but they're not zero. So, I mean, if the chance exists, it's not zero. So there is a chance. And why couldn't that be me? Like, I mean, I'm alive. That's what life is, right? So why don't I just try for this? And like, well, he became an astronaut, obviously, which is why he gets to tell the story. But the truth is, whatever your idealized life looks like, the whole point of this thing is to go for it. Fuck the odds. Fuck what holds you back. You know, fuck how hard it is. Like, that's what this is. It's a process. It's the process of developing yourself into all that you actually could be. So ask the question, where have you let yourself slide in relation to your own ideal of what a good human should be? What are you not holding yourself accountable to? The answer to that question might fix whatever is broken or keeping you static in your life. The answer to that question, as it turns out, could change your entire life. But I guess that's why people don't change, they evolve. At least that's a story that I'm sticking to. I love you guys. We'll talk tomorrow on Morning Coffee.
To make you want me, I can fabricate the truth. I'll give you easy, it'll keep me destitute. You hang me up on the line, hang me out to dry, and you got nothing to lose.
Chances say it again.